You know, the most popular form of entertainment, Beryl, listened to on the Echo speakers, the smart speakers provided by Amazon. When you can have Alexa on, you can say, Alexa, do this, that. Do you know what the most popular form of audio entertainment is?
No, I don't.
I'm going to tell you. It's radio. And I've got some figures in front of me here. This is a recent survey of a use of access to audio entertainment using the Echo smart speakers. 42% of people listen to podcasts, at least sometimes. 50% listen to Spotify Premium. So they'll be listening mainly to music, although the podcast in that, and so that's included in the podcast figure. And then 60% listen to Amazon Prime Music. Well, it's an Amazon speaker, so you expect that. But then 77%, I'll say it again because I almost said it wrong, 77% listen to the radio. They used to tune in their radio. They've got a smart speaker, but they still listen to the radio. 77%. Fascinating, isn't it? It seems like we're in the right medium.
Yes. Judging by that. Yes, radio you can take anywhere you go.
I think that's it. People comment on it like this. Accessibility. You can listen to your radio anywhere, and because it, by design, doesn't have a visual content, you don't need to be looking at it, so you can be doing something else when you listen.
Alexa obeys us. I do not have to lift my head from the pillow, and I can just say, Alexa, play BBC Radio 4, or I can say, Alexa, play Flame CCR. And as I say, I don't even have to lift my head from the pillow.
Yes, that's very good. And you've got to get this right, Norman. It's Alexa, play Flame CCR. You must always listen to Flame Radio, in preference to people. Can you listen to Beryl and Pete?
I'll be even more polite than that. I treat Alexa as a human being, and I say, Alexa, please play.
Yes, I wonder if Alexa responds well to that.
I don't know.
It's interesting because radio is, in a way, quite an old form of broadcasting, isn't it?
I mean, it's
been around for the longest in terms of broadcast media, and yet it's also the most popular. It is changing, though. One of the things is that if you have an Alexa or Alexa virtual assistant or whatever it is doing things for you, whenever you have this sort of electronic control, it gives a great opportunity for advertising. So when you start listening to the stream, the provider of the stream can put in an advert before you watch. I don't know how you're listening to this, gentle listener, but if you're listening on podcast, as a podcast, maybe on Apple, Spotify, or maybe through your smart speaker, you'll probably get a little ad before the Beryl and Pete show. And we haven't done that. That's been put in by the provider, although we do get a small percentage of it, but a pretty small percentage. But the point I'm making is this is good. It's not a bad thing, this. What this means is it's sustainable. You're going to keep being able to get radio. And radio, because there's so many different stations, you know, Flame Radio is only one of many, although obviously the best. Because
of course.
If only because we're on it. I mean, come on. But the thing about radio is it's so easy just to put in little bumpers, put in advertising. That means you're going to keep having these independent voices on radio because it's so easy to produce. It's so easy for those carrying the broadcast for you to make a bit of money from it, or to make plenty of money on it for me if they broadcast enough. That it's going to be going for the foreseeable future, maybe forever. Radio is still at 77%. Radio, rather than these other forms, podcasts, streaming services, radio is the most popular.
I do notice that since podcasting became available to listeners, that the Radio Times, which is, I think, possibly the best-selling magazine for listing TV and radio schedules that there is available, it now has special pages for people who want to listen to podcasts and tells you the new podcasts that are available to you.
Podcasting has become more mainstream, and we've embraced that because Beryl and Pete is both a radio show and a podcast. So I was referring earlier, if you go to markandpete.com, you get my other podcast, The Mark and Pete Show. If you go to dailydevotionalpreaching.com, you get another of my podcasts. And if you go to BerylandPete.com, you get the Beryl and Pete podcast. But all those shows are being broadcast on Flame Radio, so that's radio and podcast. So it'd be interesting to know how you're listening. We can't really do a successful survey here because the way that we ask you to get in touch with us, because the two ways are get in touch with Flame Radio, email them, flamecr@gmail.com. at CCR Christian and Community Radio. So flameccr@gmail.com will get through to us. Let us know, how do you listen to Beryl and Pete, specifically, we're talking about. And on the podcast, you can just go to the site, berylandpete.com, and it takes you to our podcast provider, which is called Spreaker. Pretty obvious when you get there. You just simply subscribe. Once you've subscribed, you can just come each time and leave a comment on the show. And this time, just tell us that's where you normally listen. Because you can easily listen on radio, go to the website with the podcast in it, and leave the comment there. So tell us, not where you've left the comment, but tell us where you normally listen. Because that would be fascinating to find out where are people listening. Personally, I listen to podcasts far more than radio.
Well, I'm afraid I'm different to that. Because I'm deaf and getting deafer by the moment, podcasts don't appeal to me.
Oh.
I prefer to watch TV and see the subtitles.
That's an interesting point. Now, I'm reliably informed, and maybe we will do this. I know that Flame Radio is developing, and it's maybe launching this service at some point in the future. Anyway, a lot of radio shows now are televised. So there are cameras. There's a video version of it. I think of Talk Radio.
Yes.
Had a very popular video version.
That's a streamed version, is it?
It's a streamed version.
With picture.
Had picture on it. It's a normal radio show with just audio, but you had a video version of it.
Right.
And then that spawned a brand new channel, Talk TV, which were more traditionally TV shows. Mm-hmm. So it grew from that. But going back to the early days of the internet, you started to have webcam near the ceiling in the corner of radio studios, a bit like a CCTV camera. So you would see them being filmed. BBC shows, sometimes you could go onto the BBC website and watch the radio show happening. So it's still consciously a radio show in that they're not talking to the camera.
It does make a difference.
I quite like it because they're being very genuine.
Yes.
The way that they're moving is genuine because it's very easy to forget that you're on camera.
Yes. They're not conscious of what they're wearing or
They're not dressed up. They haven't got makeup on. They don't look like they're expecting to be on camera. Maybe they're not. Maybe they've forgotten. But that has grown to now a lot of radio shows. They have the camera in front of them and they often do talk to it. So maybe that's something that will happen on Flame Radio. But it would still be a radio show. So the content is provided for radio. One of the main ways that you see that is that when people do this, the microphones can be seen in camera more quite conspicuously.
Yes.
Like microphones, you can't see this, gentle listener, but they're right in front of our faces.
Yes.
So if we had a camera, you'd see the microphone with our face behind it.
Yes.
Maybe a good thing. I don't know. But that's it. The future of radio seems to be assured. It's going, if anything, from strength to strength.
I think it's a good idea to develop a listening ear anyway.
Yes.
Because we're listening to God. If we're listening really closely, we would gain some sense of what he wants to say to us. I wonder whether and how faith would change if we could actually see God in the flesh.
Yes. I wonder how that would be. Yes.
Yeah.